Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome, one and all, to a Let's Play of the one, the only, Dungeon Master. Note that this is not a blind Let's Play. I played it when I was a lot younger, back in 1990. Scared the hell out of me. There were really no games with sounds and dynamic lighting like this. Maybe there was a few of them, but this game was really scary for its time. I played it again about 6 to 8 months ago. Finished it. Still scary at night if you have the lights off, but after playing through Silent Hill and Undying and games like that, it's fine now. Well, this is the first real-time 3D RPG game. Ever. Eye of the Beholder, Lands of Lore, the later Might and Magic games, Wizardry 8, all influenced by this. 3D, real-time action, all this. This is version 3.6, re-released, licensed by Psygnosis, the original game came out in 1987. This version came out in 1992. You can bang on the walls. It makes an actual sound. I can't do it here because I don't have any characters yet. But I'll show you what I mean in a bit. There are some walls later on in the dungeon that are illusionary. Illusory, whatever you want to call it. We have things like hooks. It's decorative purposes only. You can't do anything with those. Just looking for. Okay. Here's number one. This is Hulk. Now, you can see their stats if you click the eye. Journeyman Fighter. He is one of three Journeyman Fighters in the game. I'm not sure exactly how the level progresses. And after a certain point I do, it begins with, I believe, Novice, and then Neophyte, and then Apprentice. I might have Neophyte and Apprentice mixed up somewhat, but I know after those three is Journeyman, and then Craftsman, and then your Master, and it goes Master 1, 2, 3. And there's three or four levels of Master, and then your Archmaster, Archmaster, or something like that. You could also look at what they have, which doesn't tell you anything, just tells you how much it weighs. But when you pick up scrolls, you can look at it with the eye. He has Barbarian Hide, which basically looks like some kind of loincloth. Sandals, club. Here's his health. Stamina. After fighting for a while, your stamina goes down. He has no mana. But if you give him mana items, you can actually train him up and he can use magic. He's never going to have a lot of mana, though. You'll be lucky if he can throw two fireballs by the time the game's done. This is how much he's carrying, how much he can carry. And there's his strength, dexterity, wisdom, vitality, anti-magic and anti-fire. Obviously determine how well you resist against magic and fire, respectively. So, what we're going to do is we're going to reincarnate. Reincarnating, the advantage of reincarnating is you get to rename your champion to whoever you want him to be. The disadvantage is that the levels go away. So he's going to be back, he's going to be like below a novice. He's not even going to have a rank. but they do progress in skills very quickly. And the other advantage to reincarnate is that their stats will be slightly higher. I'm not sure by how much or how it works, but anyway, we're going to reincarnate him. And I'm going to name him after an ogre character that I played in EverQuest. So he's obviously inspired by Conan. That's him. You can go like this. Bash. You could throw your item. And put it there. Okay, so anyway. That's what I mean. Some of these walls can be illusionary. Well, obviously they're not going to be in here, and not in the first few levels at least of the game. But in version 1.0, the only way you could tell if a wall was real or not is to go like this. Yep, you lost 2 hit points. It's real. So, that's that. And, just want to see if I'm going the right way. I think I am. Sonya. Inspired by Sonya, the character from Conan. And she had her own movie as well. I'm going to reincarnate her. I don't think this is going to fit. Maybe Amethyst. Okay. So, for some reason, the last name can be a lot longer. She's reincarnated. She actually comes with her own sword, a halter, and a gunna, which seems like some kind of skirt. Excellent fighting material. sandals, just like Sunder. She's got a choker. I believe the choker's just decorative. And there's her items. She's another... Yeah, I didn't look at her before I reincarnated her, but she is one of the other three. She is one of the other journeyman fighters in the game. I don't remember who the third is, so I'm not going to be going for the third one. These are my two fighters, and that's good for me. Although they're primarily fighters, I can level them all up in their respective skills. There's wizard and priest spells. Priest spells are mainly healing and such, and buffing up your stats and such like that. And of course wizard, you know, everyone knows fireballs. There's magic torches, there's poison cloud. You'll see all this stuff to come. Anyway, just a quick look at this. If you're familiar with the game, just bear with me. I'm just going over this for people who aren't. This is your little pouch here. This is your quiver to hold rocks, arrows, what have you, daggers. Obviously your hands, this is where you wear stuff on your body. And this looks at items, or looks at your stats. And this is what you use to eat or drink. And this is your backpack and what you can hold. So, we're gonna fill that up very quickly. This is save. I'm not going to be using this because it takes forever. I'm going to be save stating, and the other reason is this, you only get one save slot, like Eye of the Beholder. This sleep? Okay, yeah, sleep to regain your stats quicker. Alright. And, yeah, that's about it. Your food and water bars. Show you how much food and water you have, obviously. When the food and water go down, you start, when it runs out, you start to lose hit points. And unlike Eye of the Beholder, you can actually directly die from starvation. A lot easier than elsewhere. So where's... trying to remember. Just bear with me. I think he's back here. Ta-da! Gothmog! Before I resurrect him, reincarnate him, rather. He is a journeyman wizard. He does have pretty good strength and health for a magic user. So, the interesting thing he has also is this, he has a cloak of knight, which gives you plus 8 dexterity. So, otherwise 35. Dexterity is 43. You could also wear this on your neck and still get the bonus. So, we're going to reincarnate him. I'm going to keep the name Gothmog because I just really like it. It's a character from Lord of the Rings. I believe it's actually two characters named Gothmog. Anyway, so that's all he comes with, this Cloak of Night. It's just because it's one of the few magic items you can get off a character when you find it with the character. We have one more to get. And... it would be... this way. Sorry guys, I'm just trying to remember. That's not him. There he is. It's Woof, the Beaker. Apprentice ninja and novice priest. So he's going to be our ninja and priest, basically. Like I said, that's just going to be in general, because eventually all of them can cast, except for maybe Sunder, all of them can cast magic spells. We can work on Sunder, too. We just have to find a magic item to give him so he has some mana. Something a plus 2 mana or something at least. Comes with an empty flask for making potions. In this game, you heal by making potions that the character can later drink. And you don't heal directly for some reason. But he absolutely comes with a leather jerkin, which is pretty good. And his stats. Well, he actually... he has the second highest amount of mana in the game. He does have the highest luck out of everyone. Luck is a hidden skill. Not shown on here. I couldn't tell you what his luck is. I just remember that's higher than anyone else I looked at. Which is everyone else. He does have the highest dexterity, of course. 57 dexterity to start. Really good. So... anyway, I'm choosing these characters for their stats and because I like them. So, I got to mention, Sunder has the second highest health of anyone in the game. So, I really don't like Wolf, but I think this is a cooler name. Wolf. Similar. But yeah, you can see his health is 90. Second highest health in the game, 65, 60, 40, everyone else really low. That's about it. That's our group. Now, we have to get out of here. Later in the game, you find a compass. It's a couple levels down. Here we go. Pressure plate. Apple. Notice how it looks rotten until you get up close. But yeah, like I said, you can die from eating in this game, and your food can run out really rapidly. In the lower levels, there's really hardly any food to be found. You end up getting food by slaughtering your enemies and chopping them up. Grizzly outside silence. But can't be any more nasty than eating food up off the floor. Here's a water skin filled with water. You get 3 gulps out of this. And it's empty. You can refill it at a fountain. Here's a scroll, which we can look at. Invoke full for a magic torch. Get to that in a minute. Stairs down, but we're not going down that way just yet. This is the altar, the V, altar of rebirth. That's the sign for V. New lives for old bones. Well, what happens? Now, if your character dies, their bones appear on the ground with all their items. So you put their bones in here and they come back to life. The only problem is finding one of these things. They're pretty common on the upper levels when you really don't need them. But when you get down to the tougher levels, they're nowhere to be found, often. Is some corn? Dungeon floor corn. Button door. There's another apple. And some cheese. Anyone not have food? Yeah. And bread. Give me that. Some nice, fresh dungeon bread. Who would walk through here and just drop cheese and bread and hit me? Yeah. I'm full. Let me just drop this on the floor. Without any further ado, into darkness. Now, here's the spell they were talking about. Full for a magic torch. First of all, the spells are cast in a series of runes, I guess these are. So, the first level of runes is the intensity or power of the spell. This is the lowest amount, and basically get up, this is the highest amount. If you're casting a fireball with this, pretty good. So, we're just starting out. We gotta start out with the lowest. This is full. F-U-L. Full. As you can see, we got it a little lighter. Needs more practice. Ta-da. And he's not the only one who can cast this. Anyone with mana can cast this spell. Now, for some reason, when you're standing here, if you turn around, you end up at the top of the stairs again. But I'm sure you guys. Isn't there a... No, I guess not. I thought there was a water fountain up here. No, okay, we got one downstairs. There are no monsters on this level. This is considered level 0. Often. As you can see, it's a little dimmer. And as you use these spells, they'll go up in levels also. It's gonna take a while. Here's a club. And we hear something banging around in the night. We need this club. Oh! There it is. Well, we haven't found anything to throw. So we're just gonna have to hack at it. I could open this later, but why not? I threw it. Okay. They're really easy, but if they can gang up on you. Definitely. So in here we have some goodies. This level's pretty easy. The game doesn't open its whoop ass for a little while. Small details can hide great rewards. You mean like this? Ta-da! Falchion. Much better than a club. Dagger. For a wolf to throw. And that's it, down here. Gold key. Like I said, I try to be informative. Or, I might not have said that. Try to be informative as I can. I shouldn't have even put the gold key away, because we got a keyhole. Introduction to keys and keyholes. Put the key in, that's how it works. It's wonderful. Now, if our spells go out, because this is gonna, the light's gonna dim again, eventually. If our spells go out, we also got this torch. Or, yeah, Wolf has a torch. You can peer around corners. Like that. Unlike Eye of the Beholder, if you peer around a corner, the monster doesn't see you. In Eye of the Beholder, if you peer around a corner, the monster will see you and 9 times out of 10 start heading your way. Alright, here's a fountain, of course. You can drink from it.
No.
The character highlighted here is who's drinking.
No.
Also considered the character leader, if you actually just pick this up and throw it, that's considered to be Amethyst throwing it. If you throw it directly, then that's Wolf throwing it. So, I'm not sure. As far as I know, you can't change the order of these. That's why I went to each character in the order I did. I just like to have my fighters here and my other guys in the back. But in the back rows, you can't hit somebody with a contact weapon. You need ranged. So, daggers, rocks, arrows, what have you. Alright, so. Who has this thing? You can drink this. I don't know if you can even drink it.
No. No. No.
As you can see, it's all shriveled up and empty. Do that, fill it up. You can also, instead of putting a potion here, you can fill them with water. And we'll probably do that, because there are no fountains after a certain level. Very rare to find. Yeah, we don't have any keys, so we can't go this way. We found a key here, but I'm going to continue going down the way we were going. I think there's another gate beyond that one anyway, so we need 2 keys. And we do not have it. There's a door. Alright, we're not going to go that way right now. There's something in there. There's another enemy. I don't know if this key is for that, but we better try. Alright, no it isn't. So I'm not going to see that enemy just yet. Here's a rock. Yeah, I hear you. That's one way to get past that. Alright, let's see if this key works here then. No, okay. Then I have to go back. Yeah, you can hear them. It's funny because the way this works, the sounds you're hearing could be from behind a wall, and it sounds just as loud as if there was nothing there. So, here we've got a simple switch. Portcullis of sorts. And another switch. Welcome to pits. That will be the easiest pit, probably, that we'll ever find. Leather boots. Anyone not have footwear? Yeah, both of them don't. They might improve your armor class, I'm not entirely sure. So now we have another key, gold key. So we have two of these things, so we might be able to get in with one of all those other doors. This game is pretty linear. For the most part, you don't have to... I think I'm going back to where I was. You don't have to go up and down levels and all around. Yeah, I'm going the wrong way. Back to the stairs. Pretty much you're kind of all over the level you are, and then once you find the stairs, if you found everything on that level, you're good. You probably won't have to go back unless you're looking for an altar of rebirth or a fountain. Ah. No, sometimes that scares me. I don't know that's going to happen. It's easy to get lost in here because the walls all look the same. Alright. I doubt we can open both of these, but let's give it a try. Wrong key. So you got a second key. Huh, okay. We got stuff. Elven doublet. Name with me, something to put on your hairy chest, Sunder. Here's another dagger. And an arrow. Not sure if I can actually throw that as a weapon. I can. Yeah, okay. Good enough. I think you'll find a bow later in the game, but I'll have to do for now. Here's another torch. And another key. So someone's been nice enough to leave all these keys and things laying around, so we can get to where we're going. I'm trying to remember which way I came from. He has really low stamina. Just by walking around, he can get tired. Alright. Yep. Losing our light. I prefer to use their spells whenever possible because we need to train these levels up. Now he's totally out of mana. Gothmog. I know they need more practice. We are practicing. Alright, it's not completely up to full. I like it to be nice and bright if possible. So, once you have the torch on, it's fine. Once their mana goes up, I'll, you know, if I remember, I'll take the torch out and cast spells. Oh, I'm going back. There's no auto map in this game, so this is, it's easy to get lost in here. So, this is where we were. Yes. Dead end. Okay, guys. Are you kidding me? Okay. If this key goes in here, we'll get to fight something. Ah! Yeah. Two of them. Okay. It's gotta go in this one, guys. Okay. Another falchion. Not sure, it might do better damage than the regular sword, couldn't tell ya. It's hard to know in this game because they don't tell you how much damage a weapon does. Here's a little key that you could maybe not even see. Solid key. And an iron key. So, we've got keys. Get through those doors. G trousers. Something like that. Alright, well. We'll be mismatched for a little while. Gotta take what you can get. Well, we've been running for quite a while. Like to thank you for watching, and hope to see you in the next video. And, yeah, take care. Bye-bye.